Let them ridicule us. They might occasionally mention some of the good we do.
That's not the point. There's no truth in the stuff he printed, and it's up to us as a group to prove it.
I've always wanted to pound a picket line.
Now, Martha, you remember the night you saw Queen Elizabeth? In all her clothes, taking a bath in your own tub?
Are you suggesting by any chance that I had too many absence frappes?
Well, we must exhaust all possibilities before we devote our lives to a corpse hunt.
After all, darling, you're the only one who says it was a murder.
I did see the body, and my cloak certainly didn't run off by itself.
Well, maybe the body wasn't dead.
I would have told the police that you saw Ronnie Belden coming out of the Lane house. I didn't have a chance.
I think it's foolish to get any more mixed up in this murder.
No, it isn't. Mels is right. If we don't do something quickly, the whole town will believe everything Ames and that stupid police inspector said about us.
Well, I think it's silly, but I'm with you.
Me too.
Count me in.
Same here.
Oh, that's swell, girls. I've called Ronnie Belden's apartment, and the switchboard operator says he won't be in till late tonight. Meanwhile, I have some flashlights. Let's all go over to the Lane house. I'll prove I'm not crazy.
Can't we prove you're not crazy some other night?
Sure. We'll ask the murderer not to touch a thing.
Telephone for you, Miss Frost.
Oh, well, there's my day.
Sounds like a pipsqueak to me.
Hello, pipsqueak. I mean, hello, Paul. No, I can't. Well, just a minute. Please, not tonight. Oh, hello? Hello? Hello, are you there? Oh, he was cut off.
Poor boy, and in the prime of his life, too. Hilda, the door.
I heard it. I ain't deaf. Sometimes I wish I was.
Have you another piece of paper? Hilda?
Yes, I have, but the kitchen's closed for the night.
Hilda, Miss Beverly is our guest.
I didn't ask her.
Comes the revolution and we'll stop being exploited by our help.
In my house, the revolution is here.
Well, look, I was told to give this to Miss Manton personally. You're Miss Manton?
Yes, thank you.
Send a request and answer, please.
May I come up and see you? Just want half hour of your time. Peter Ames. That's our publicity agent.
Have him up. We'll give him something to write about.
The answer is no.
Oh, in that case, here's another telegram for you.
Okay, child. You think they'd send an older man up to this here apartment?
I'm coming up anyway. Peter Ames.
Too bad we won't be here to greet him.
Oh, I'd better call the Lanes at their hotel so they won't surprise us at the old house.
What'll I say?
Say hello.
Oh, thanks, Dora. You're sweet and very helpful. Mr. Lane, please. Oh, well, then Mrs. Lane.
Oh, did she? Did she take a bag?
Thank you very much. George Lane is out of town. Sheila left yesterday after dinner and hasn't been back since.
Do you suppose she and Ronnie Belden skipped? You've heard about those two.
I don't know which is more pernicious, you or Anemia.
That'll be your editor.
Duck your flashlight. Remember, girls, I want the first stab at him.
Now, don't be selfish, Melissa.
Oh, my cloak!
The next time, you'll be in it.
Oh, the murderer's been here.
Yes. Why didn't I keep that date? What'll we do?
I don't know. Think for yourself.
Whoever committed the murder did this and is afraid we may know something.
That knife ain't for opening letters.
We can't let this intimidate us. That's what the murderer wants. It's all the more reason.
Oh, he's come back.
And I'm leaving.
I'm going to open the door. Get ready, girls. We'll rush him. Oh.
Very nice props, but they don't convince me.
You fool! You ruined the fingerprint.
Did I? I can get you plenty more fingerprints. Miss Manton and I came up to see if I couldn't talk you out of this childishness. You can't possibly win. Besides, it'll just make a lot of trouble for both of us.
Come on, girls.
Hi, old Silver.
Nasty man.
I'll take mine in $1 bills.
Rigor mortis is setting in.
He's cute.
Come on.